Earlier this week, I interviewed former porn actor, director, producer, and author Dave Pounder, and he was talking about people being fired for having participated in movies that may have been sexually explicit or maybe contain nudity. In spite of those acting gigs, for lack of a better term, being legal. And we now have an incredible story just days after interviewing Dave Pounder about a 73-year-old instructor at an elite Montreal private school who has lost her job after it was discovered she appeared nude in European films more than 40 years ago. The prestigious Brebeuf College has terminated the contract of Jacqueline Laurent Auger after some male high school students uncovered her early acting repertoire online. Her early films included such titles as The Secret Diary of a Nymphomaniac, dated back to the 1960s and 70s when she was a struggling actress just out of theater school in Montreal, moved to Paris, and as she said, "I did it as a young actress to make a little money. The idea of throwing someone out the door for something they did almost 50 years ago is idiotic. It makes me angry." This is a Jesuit-founded institution that has groomed such leaders as Pierre Trudeau and his son Justin. They're being accused of essentially retroactive slut-shaming, which I think is a pretty good characterization of what this is, Lewis.
I suppose. And that's still a weird term for me when, I don't know. It just strikes me as odd, especially in situations where this could just be considered, an artistic expression as opposed to pornography.
Which, yeah, no, you're actually making a good point, which is although those calling it retroactive slut shaming have the best of intentions in mind, it may actually not be that accurate.
Yeah. But anyway, yes, this is unfortunate. I don't know if she can fight this, if she will fight this. She's right. It's idiotic.
What the school said is, quote, "The fact that these films were shot 40 years ago doesn't change their bold and suggestive, even explicit character. The students' discovery of their teachers' films affected the atmosphere in class." Legal activity, half a world away, 40 years ago. It's amazing that just days after Dave Pounder told us this is an issue, we have one of the most egregious examples of it. We're not even talking here about pornography.
Mm-hmm. I don't think anyone was murdered or anything like that. Perhaps the school sees it as some type of distraction. And I don't think it should be, I don't think this should be legal. But of course, private businesses still, or schools, to some extent, need to be able to fire people based on decisions those people have made. But where do you draw the line?